Good morning, my name is Engineer Piyush Pandey. Welcome to today's session of Motivational Skills. And the topic for today's discussion is getting job through someone's reference. Ladies and gentlemen, getting jobs through someone's reference is often considered in different manners by different people. Sometimes we feel that since we are not capable of qualifying any interview, we are not knowledgeable enough, that's why we require references to get selected in a particular organization. Some people believe that if you are knowledgeable enough, you are intelligent enough, definitely you will qualify any kind of interview related to your profile, and definitely you can get the job according to your choice. But it is not true, ladies and gentlemen. The reality is something else. Let me give you a real life example. When any organization hires employees for a big project for which more than 100 people are required approximately, in that case, organization organizes bulk hiring schedule. In bulk hiring schedule, interviews are held at company's premises and large number of candidates are allowed to participate in that interview because company requires large number of employees. Not only this, company deals with certain consultancy services also and guides them that you hire employees according to our needs and desires, and in return we will pay you some money. So in case of a big project, the organization also organizes a walk-in interview within the company premises. Along with that, when the number of required candidates are more, the organization also takes help from consultancy services. Now, this is the case where organization wants to hire candidates for a big project where a large number of people are required. It is a bulk hiring scenario. Now, see one more different case. Sometimes organizations do not require to hire candidates in bulk, but whenever there is a situation vacant within the organization, to fill that specific situation, organization tries to take help from the people who are already working inside the organization, and that is known as hiring through referral. Hiring through referral. Now suppose you are working as a finance executive in the organization. Because of some reason, you leave the organization and your situation is vacant. Your position is vacant. Now there is no one inside the organization to fill your position. That's why there is a criteria of notice period in any organization. Whenever you have to leave an organization, you have to serve a notice period, 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, according to the needs and requirements of the organization. Why you have to serve the notice period? Because you already mentioned well in advance that on this particular date, after 1 month or 2 months, you will be leaving the organization, and organization becomes alert, and before you leave the organization, organization hires the same candidate of your quality, of your qualification, of your experience, so that as soon as you leave the organization, immediately some other person is ready to take your position. That is why there is a system of notice period in any organization. Now, if I talk about referrals, sometimes when such kind of people leave organization in such a manner, organizations want internal employees to give references of someone known to them so that the vacant position can be filled appropriately. Instead of launching a big event of bulk hiring, just for hiring two or three people, it's a hectic schedule and it's a waste of finance also in a certain manner. That's why organizations prefer to talk to the internal employees and request them that if you have any candidate, if you know someone who is having the kind of experience and knowledge that we require, you please bring that candidate to us. We will give him the appropriate job. In this way, the person will get the job. Along with that, our requirements will be fulfilled appropriately. And in return, we will give you certain financial benefits. Now, organizations tell their internal employees that if you provide us more employees, we will give you some financial benefits in return. So it will be a dual benefit. You will get certain financial benefit and we will get a good employee. Now, there is no meaning in feeling humiliated when you are getting hired by some referral. Sometimes people have this misconception in their mind that since they are getting hired through a referral, it is not good. They would have tried their best. They would have tried on their own to get that particular job instead of talking to some referral. But this is not true, ladies and gentlemen. When you get hired through a referral, the responsibility on your shoulders is more as compared to when you join by qualifying the interview yourself. Now see this difference. Either you qualify the interview of the organization through walk-in interview or you get hired through a referral. When you qualify the interview through your own effort, you have to prove that you are the good employee for the organization. You have to work hard to show that you really deserve that position that you got through walk-in interview. When you get selected by your own self-effort, by the mode of walk-in interview, it is your responsibility to prove it to the organization that you are a good candidate for that particular position. You are a hard-working person, you are a knowledgeable person, you are a dedicated person. You have to prove it. Only then organization will consider that you are a good employee. And the second case, when you get hired through referral, when you get hired by someone's help who is already working inside the organization, there are more responsibilities. First of all, you will have to show that you are a good employee. Secondly, you should try your best to prove that by hiring you, the organization has not done any mistake. Because if you do anything wrong as an employee of the organization will fire you. Along with that, the organization will fire that candidate who helped you to get that job, who referred you. So if you do anything wrong, you will be fired. Along with that, the person will also be fired who referred your name to the organization that yes, please hire this person. So when you get hired through a referral, responsibility is more on your shoulders. Responsibility is always more. When you qualify the interview yourself, you are the boss. You qualified the interview because you knew the answers of the questions that were asked by the HR, and that's why the HR hired you. Now you're the part of the organization. When you get hired through a referral, first of all, you got hired through a referral. You were not able to face any kind of interview hectic schedule. The person was already known to you. He told the manager, okay, he is known to me, please hire him, he is a nice person. And the manager said that, okay, since you are a hardworking employee and you are referring him, we are not going to take his interview, we are directly hiring him. And when you get directly hired without any interview because someone is known to you in the industry already, in that case, the responsibility on your shoulders is always more. First of all, you did not get hired by interview. So you have to prove to the organization that even if you got hired directly by someone's referral, still you are the right candidate for the position that the organization has given to you. You are the right candidate for that position and you will have to prove it. If you are able to prove it that yes, I actually deserved this position, only then organization will respect you. And the organization will also respect that person who got you inside the organization. Organization will think that yes, since this person was already a dedicated person inside the organization, he got another person of the same quality. That's why we are very happy. But if you are not working inside the organization with full dedication after getting hired, first of all, organization will fire you. And secondly, at the same time, organization will fire that person who got you into that organization, saying that he provided a non-productive employee to the company. He provided a non-productive employee to the company. The company organized interview for this person. The company wasted enough time in checking this person's credibility, and then this person was hired on the basis of referral, on the basis of initial talk, initial interview phase, which was not a hectic interview schedule, but just an introductory session. So organization hired a person on someone's referral, and now this person is not working with full dedication. This person is not showing any commitment level towards the organization. Definitely that person will be fired. Along with that, the person will be fired, that person will be fired who referred that employee. So if the referred person is not performing well, it will take away a job of two people at the same time. Two people will be fired from the organization at the same time. First, the candidate, and second, the person who referred that candidate. So ladies and gentlemen, even if you are getting job through a referral, please don't think that it is wrong in any manner. It is not wrong. Organizations, they themselves desire that some referred candidate must come to their organization. Referrals are required by the organization. It is not only your need that you are looking for someone known to you inside the organization by the help of which you can get the job in a particular organization. Organizations also require such people. So there is no feeling of, there should be no feeling of humiliation in your mind when you are getting hired through a referral. You just need to keep this thing in your mind that once you get hired, you have to work with full dedication and full concentration inside the organization in the direction of the aims of the organization. If you are not working with full dedication after getting hired through a referral, it will lead to degradation of your reputation. Along with that, it will lead to the degradation of the reputation of the person who got you inside the organization. So when you get hired through a referral, you have to take care of your reputation. Along with that, you have to take care of the reputation of the person who got you into that organization. The stakes are higher, the responsibilities are higher, the commitment level should be higher. Prove it to your organization that you are the right candidate, and that's all. Doesn't matter how you are getting hired inside the organization. It is not important how you are getting hired. Important is, after getting hired, what kind of dedication and commitment level you are showing towards the organization. That is important. That's all for today, ladies and gentlemen. I hope that you loved my today's video. Please subscribe my channel, ER Piyush Pandey, Trainer at VTech MBA. And please press the bell icon for constant updates. Thank you very much. Have a great day.